everyone. Let's do a quick demo today on how capable the IBM POWER9 processor could be. My test bench is the Raptor computing system Blackbird workstation motherboard with the IBM POWER9 8-core V2 running 64 gig of RAM, DDR4 ECC, and my GPU is the Gigabyte Radeon Vega 64 8 gig of HBM RAM, and my hard drive is the 950 Pro Samsung NVMe running on the PCIe Express Gen 4, but obviously it's cap of Gen 3, by the way, but it's fast enough. As you can see here, this is the 8-core system, and because I buy the Sforza POWER9 is a 4-way, so each of the core is, you can see that is like, I have like 4 thread here, so I have 32 thread, a lot of like computing power. So let's see if it actually be able to code video clips. So the first test I'm going to run here is the 4K 256 megabit per second H264 video. Let's see how it works. So you can see right now the video play very smoothly, and let's have a look into the H-top. You can see here the CPU are crunching right now, pretty okay. The average temperature, let's have a look at that. So it was jumping from 4950 to 5151. Still pretty okay. Not heating up too much. Okay, so the video clip has ended. So I can conclude that the CPU can cope with the H264 in 4K easily, no problem at all. This is full on CPU, no GPU acceleration in here. Right, let's try now with the H265, right? This is H265 in a 10-bit. Let's see how it performs. Unlike H264 decoding, H265 is supposed to be more efficient, but more taxing on the CPU as well. And in this case, you can see here, it's actually quite sluggish. Definitely, there are frames being dropped at the moment. Let's have a look into the H-top as well. Yeah, you can see that all the threads are going busy. The temperature of the core also rising up to 66 now, 69. So yeah, more work, definitely more work. You can see that very slow. Yeah, I don't know, it could be the ffmpeg 4.2 which I'm using right now hasn't optimized the H265 decoding for the POWER9 processor, so maybe in the future it will play smoothly. But let's see. I also want to demonstrate if I switch to using the GPU to decode that, you would see like a huge difference in the performance. Let's play with the, and then I will press Ctrl H to switch to VA API. Okay, now look at that. You can see that, oh, it's so smooth, right? And look at the CPU. Nothing, like nothing at all. No CPU being used at all, like completely cooled down. And yet at the same time, the video plays super smooth. This is the power of the GPU. All right, so Now let's try something different. Let's try 400 megabit per second. Also the same 4K as well. Let's see how well it goes. Yeah, same. Very slow actually. CPU is going up, getting busy, and it's slow. Lots of frame dropped. Alright, so yeah, I conclude that no boot for H265. Oh, let's just switch to hardware to see how it copes. Oh, straight away you can see the result. Straight away, everything become butter smooth. Yeah, I love it. I love the hardware acceleration. It's just so cool. Right, okay. What else? Right, let's try to play a 8K. Yeah, 8K. See how it copes. Right, I have 8K here with me. Hopefully you can be able to play it. I don't think you'll be able to play it. Okay, so this one, the 8K video clip with the H265. Let's see if it's actually playable. Whoa, no good at all. No good at all, and you can see that. You have a lot of artifact here. Pretty sure everything is going busy as well. You can see CPU, right, and temperature are rising as well. 67 now. Okay, that's like, yeah. So no good. I reckon the David codec that ffmpeg is using is not so optimized yet for the Power 9 or Power PC in general. Well, let's see if I can switch to hardware. Ooh. I see some error here in the console. How weird it does. Ah, drat. So, yeah. Hardware acceleration does not support 8K resolution. They only can go up to 4K max. So, yeah. No good. I hope like the future version of driver would support hardware acceleration for the 8K. So there you have it. If you have any question, feel free to leave the comment. Thank you.